Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to teach you guys how to design your buttons, text input, and every other thing, so you can make your projects look cooler. So, what are we waiting for? See you at the computer screen. Alright guys, now that we're back at my computer, we can go back to code.org and code.org if it works. Sign in, and then create a new project. Alright guys, so this time we're gonna add in a button, a label, a text input, a drop down, a radio button, a checkbox, text area. Yes, we can do text area. So in the button, we can, in the design area, so if you click on the button, it says ID, text, width, height. So if we wanted to say, high, we can type in high and it says high. And if we want it to be longer, like wider, we can say 150 and it's wider. And then the label, we can make it say high again, and it says high, and we can make it be longer like that or like that and all those stuff. And then it's the text input, we can say placeholder hi, what is your name or something. And then if we run it and click on it, it says hi. So, and then the radio button, it's basically like just whenever you're done with something, if you want to select something, you can press the radio button, and if you're done with something, you can press the checkbox, and it's just gonna yes or no, like that. And then the text area, you can say, you can say, hi. Say that if we run it in the run, so it says like that, and then you can make it like a question and answer. So if that's the question, you can be like answer. You can be answer. Hi, my name is Let's just do that. My name is so and so. So that's how you can design everything. And if you design it in the design area, even if you reset it, it's gonna stay. Like the hi, what is your name? Or, in the drop down, you can also make it have different options. So you can make it say name or date. That and run it. If you open up the thingy, it says everything that you said. So it's like that. And then in the radio, I'm pretty sure there's nothing you can do. Yeah, you can't do anything with the radio button unless other than like changing the width and stuff. So it was 10. It was 15. Yeah, it was 15. The checkbox, I'm pretty sure it's the same. Yeah, so it's the only thing you can do. You should say 40. It doesn't change the size though, it just goes like that. So yeah, that's that. And then we can add in a screen, which is screen two, and we can put three buttons, or any buttons that you want. And in the code, so this is the first screen. Basically, we can say on a when. This is button one, right? So we can say button one is clicked. We can say set screen, screen two. So it's basically like this. You can say hi, my name is cousin. My name is da da da. Or we can select something and we can say I choose this and then that. And then if we click the button, it's gonna go to the next area. And then I didn't code anything else. So yeah, that's like stuff you can do. And if we for some reason say Scrantu, I don't think it works. Yeah, it doesn't work. Scrantu, which does not exist. So yeah, the screen set screen Scrantu, which does not exist. Yeah, basically. It means that Scrantu is not a thing, but Scrantu is a thing. So yeah, that's another thing. And we can say whenever the button is clicked, we can say play sound, whatever that is. True. And if we turn the volume down, it sounds like this. And if you keep spamming on it, it sounds like this. Oh, and also if you press reset, it doesn't stop. So that's why you should sometimes put another button in, saying on event. Button 7 is clicked. Stop sound. And then we can keep spamming it. It's not working, I don't know why. Let me just There, refreshing the page also works, so we can be like okay, so it's kind of annoying too. So yeah. So it's high. Okay. So it makes sense, because if it's one at a time, you can stop. It says like that, stop. But if it's like so many at once, if you press stop, it doesn't stop because it doesn't stop because I didn't write that much code. Normally there's like this. Like that, more than that actually, so it's like still doesn't work, I don't know why. Maybe I'm writing the code wrong, I don't know. So let's just take that away. So yeah, that's another thing you can do. Why did I just do undo? So that's the thing you can do. Sound dot, let's go here. Okay, well it's not a thing. But it's the default code.org sound, I'm pretty sure, and that's why it's this sounding. Well, that was what I wanted to show you guys, so yeah.
Thank you for watching my video, guys. Make sure you use designing on every single project so your project looks way more awesome. So, make sure you like, subscribe, and share the video. See you guys next time. Bye!